Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme Tig channel. Hope everybody's doing good. So for today's video I'm gonna show you guys a root pass for x-ray. This is joint I have to do. It's gonna be shut. I'm gonna do x-ray. So I got a T 6 inch with vitalic fitting. For the root I'm gonna use 130 amps and I'm gonna show you the steps that I'm using and I'm doing to perform this task. So cup size 7, I like 7, fits inside perfect of that 6 inch groove. I can slide it, I can wiggle, I can walk the cup on the bottom, on the top, all the way around, whatever. So torch 150 amps, TIG torch and a stick out 1 inch tungsten. It's like up to 10 mil as always, 9 mil as you can see here. Usually for reference I like to do put on the top of the bevel and if the tip of the tungsten is touching that edge of the bevel, that's pretty much good stick out for me. I like to use that. So in this video I'm gonna show you guys proper steps I'm doing. As I said, this is for my x-ray, so if it works for me, I hope it's gonna work for you as well. As you can see here, I'm just gonna go like 15-20 degree angle for that filler wire, the way I'm feeding it from the outside. Nothing fancy, so it's not a back feed, it's just it's gonna be like constant feed. Once I get to that tack, I'm just gonna feather out those tacks. They're not really good quality tacks, I just put it to keep those two parts together. But I did some root penetration, it's not that good, I'm just gonna remeld them. As I said, just gonna keep that rod inside, start from the bottom, going up. Once I get close to that tack, I'm gonna pull it out and finish it from the outside. And just keep that rod connected, guys. Just keep it in the puddle, feed as needed, and just remelt. Once you go up, that's what I'm doing. I'm gonna show you later. So here from the bottom, make connection both sides. When it's nice, good solid liquid puddle, and then you can feed that rod and just keep it connected in the puddle. Be careful for the tip of the tungsten, you don't want to dip, you don't want to touch that puddle. You just gotta have that nice feeling how much is needed for that length, and just stretch that puddle, just push it side to side. The edges are opening, you can see, you don't have to worry, you just kind of keep it in the middle and just stretch that puddle side to side. Pretty much always in all my videos, on the bottom I'm doing a constant feed, and later on the top I'm doing dipping technique. We're gonna talk later about dipping technique and pros and cons. Okay, so you can see here, this is the partial root I done. I always like the bigger, heavier root, especially at the bottom. The here thing, usually what is happening, it's like a little pool created here on the side, especially on a thicker root, and usually on the sides, like 8 to 9 o'clock. It's like a little pool created when the puddle cools down, it just sags down and then created like a little pool. So we're gonna grind out from the outside, but you're not gonna feed the rod from outside. You want to put it inside, and as you want to continue to the same thickness of the root, you want that root to be the same size, the same shape, the same uniformity. So you're just gonna start from the inside feeding that rod. Once you want that continuation, once you start preheating, once it start melting, just add rod and just keep adding that rod. No need, I can't tell you exactly how much you have to push, it's all about feeling. This is something that you're gonna get, one more you burn, more you learn. And for the tines, actually it's not a really good tines, as I said, this is just really, I feather out those tacks really thin, I'm just gonna remelt them. But usually on the tines, and I'm gonna show you later in this video too, I just usually always pause and dipping technique, adding rod side to side, and just go over it and continue on. And pretty much now from 9 o'clock I just continue on with the dipping technique. As I said, there's a lots of reasons why dipping technique gives you better control, way better control than I can say than all other welding techniques. heat control, consistency, and efficiency. Different techniques can help you to have that consistent weld for bead size and the shape, which is of course important for producing a strong and reliable weld. I'm just going to continue on now. As you can see here, there's no, you can see that there's no that weld pull. Usually what it shows, you can see that it's not even. You can see the difference when the guys usually stop start, and especially when you got that pull and it's uneven spot. I just continue on dipping, as you can see, side to side. And it's always, for me, dipping technique is it's a basic in Tig welding. So if you don't have too much experience and you've got x-rays to pass, try with this. If you didn't try so far, as I said, the dipping technique, it give you way better control and allow you for precise adjustments, and you can produce consistent and efficient welds. Okay, now for this side is done. Okay, this is the root for so far on this side. As I said, I like nice, heavy, solid roots, as I like to run hot, especially on a hot pass. Okay, now from the bottom, now we go for the bottom on the other section. Same thing, preheat, and once it starts melting, once you get that puddle liquid, add that filler wire and just keep it inside the puddle. And guys, try to push that bead as long as you can. Less you stop, more consistent that weld is gonna look. If you got more stops, it's not gonna be uneven, especially if you don't know how to properly stop start. For that continuation, you don't want that weld to be like visible when you have stop starts. It's just for you. I mean, you can have visual stop starts, but as long as the weld is good, it's okay. But I'm just saying for you, you know, you wanna get better in that. Okay, you can see here, I went on the other side. You can see by the root pattern on two sides. Okay, now the same thing on this side. I'm just gonna feather out. I'm gonna make it really thin, that bridge stack, and I'm just gonna continue on. So constant feed is gonna be up to that 3 o'clock. 3 o'clock is on this on my side now. And then later on, I'm just gonna pull it out slowly and just keep on with the dipping technique. The good thing with the dipping technique is you put like small increments, and you also keep that heat input, keep it on a minimum, which can reduce the risk of distortion and other welding defects, of course. And as I said, you actually control the amount with that small increments that you actually putting in. Oh, now here for the tie-in, I always pause a little bit, add the rod one side, both sides, add pause a little bit, and I just go over with adding rod. Also, you, when you go over the tack, you add rod as needed. I'm just gonna show you here on a tie-in on the top. Some guys, they like to lay wire. It all depends from the size of the gap as well. You know, you can go hot, but that got some risks, you know, for the grapes, or if you miss little step, you know, when you lay wire and you wanna speed travel is fast, you can misstep and it's gonna be shown on your x-ray. And that's it for the root. Pretty much I'm happy with it. It's good solid root all the way around. As I said, I like heavier root, especially for the hot pass. I like to run really hot. So this is 130 for the root. Usually I go even 140. But I just want to show you like the proper step, as this is for x-ray. It's gonna be x-ray for me. So if you're not sure, if you dip tungsten a couple times, you can take a grinder and lightly just grind all the way around and run a buffing wheel. You want to have nice clean root from outside, just if you're not unsure. So I'm gonna go 160 for the hot pass. And now you might wonder, oh, it's gonna be sucked back or something. No, this is the reason why I'm gonna show you it also. So the travel speed is most important thing here. And the thickness of your root. So if you got really shallow root and really flush with the material, then yeah, there's a big possibility of a sack back. You definitely don't want that. And this is the result. I like 160, I like harder. Gives me nice control. I can really melt that 1/8. Melts really nice. And as you can see, there's no sack back. There's not even a zero of any inch, any millimeter of that root was being sucked back. That's it for today's video, guys. I hope you like it, hope you enjoy it. If you got any comments, feel free to comment. I'm always gonna answer. Not really active that much on Instagram and Facebook. Got lots of messages daily, just impossible to answer all of that. So feel free to comment here on YouTube and I'll try to answer. Thank you very much and see you in the next one, guys. Bye.